Hi everyone, I'm Ming, and I will be sharing with you how, as a master admin, you can create users. The flow that I'm going to start with today is to show you, as a master admin, you have access to this tab, and you can navigate to user management. On the user management page, other than viewing through the entire list of users in your organization, you can also create a user. As a master admin, there are two ways that you can create a user. I will focus on the first way, which is to invite users. To invite a user is very simple. You only will need the email address of the user that you want to invite. So I'll just enter a dummy address. You can edit the subject, and if you would like to, and then you can simply click invite. So with this, your email invite is successful. It has been sent to the email address that you have input. Let me just quickly show you how the email looks like. So this is the email address that I've entered just now, and this is what the user will receive. The user will receive an email stating that they have been invited to the customer portal, and what their new account may give them the ability to, if they have the permission for, and if they would like to, they can click activate account. I'll bring you through the activation process. So all that the user needs to do is fill in all of the profile information. They will have to enter their legal first name and last name. Let me just do this. You have to fill in all the mandatory fields. And the service desk PIN is a PIN number that they enter. And this service desk PIN is something that they use to verify their profile when, let's say, they raise a help ticket to the global service desk, and then the agent would perhaps ask them for this service desk PIN, and they can verify this, and they can proceed with the ticket if they require to. Okay. With this, they can submit. Oh, forget to add the preferred time zone. All right, with this, then an email will be sent to the master admin, and also another email will be sent to you, to the user, and if they do not receive the email, then they may have to check with the master admin again. But I would now show you how the email looks like that the master admin will receive. Okay, so if I go back to our testing email environment, so this is the master admin that I was using just now. So the master admin has now received the notification that the new user registration was submitted, and they have to approve the user registration, and you're given the instructions of how you can approve this user. Okay, so basically you have to go in the customer portal, and there's a link in the message center. So this link is over here. Now that I'm back in the master admin's page, if I go to this bell icon here, which will direct me to the message center. Oh, I think this wasn't refreshed yet. Let me just do a simple refresh of this page to show you. Okay, it should be here. Yes, so you see that the user that I've registered just now is over here. So by clicking to this, I'll be redirected to approve this user. Okay, the user status is pending approval. And now I can either view the user's profile, approve the registration, or reject the registration. If I were to reject the registration, then the user will not be able to access ECP. Okay, after approving this registration, you would notice that there is a success message whereby it says that the newly added users will be inactive until permissions are assigned to them. If a user is inactive, the user will not be able to access ECP. Okay, so what happens is you have to assign permissions to this user. I shall just do this uncheck. And this user over here will appear. So the status has been updated from pending approval to not activated. And in order to activate this user, I will have to manage the permission of this user. Okay, by assigning any permissions, even one permission, okay, you would activate the status of this user. All right, by doing so, let me go back. So I was editing this user earlier, and now you can see that this user now is active, and the user already has one single permission and they have portal access already. Okay, so now that this user is active, the master admin will now be able to manage the permissions, copy permissions, reset password, deactivate or activate a user. So this is the first way a user can be created in portal, by directly inviting the user to the user profile through them creating their own user profile. All right. The user themselves, they would also receive an email telling them that their request to register has also been approved, and they can now access the portal by logging in with the username and the password that they have created before. Okay. So now, going back to a create user flow, this is the second way of adding a user, which is through the add user function. In the first way, through invite user, you would notice that you have only input the user's email address of the one that you wanted to invite. However, for adding user, you are required to input the key information of the user. So you must make sure that you have this information on hand. Okay, things like the user's first name, last name, email, company, and the country code and work phone. These are mandatory fields that have to be filled up before this can be successful. Okay. I will go ahead and create one. So with these, you can simply click submit and this user profile will be created in ECP. Do note that there is also some other features on this page that you can use. You can create multiple users at the same time by clicking this add more user. You can fill up the fields if you have the information, and by submitting it, you'll be creating more than one user at one time. You can also set a future deactivation date if this user is someone whom you do not want them to access ECP for an extended period of time. You can also assist to set the language and time zone for the user if you know. And it is currently defaulted to the same as your own time zone. Okay, and with this, I'll click a submit. And the same success message would be shown to you, notifying you that the newly added user is actually inactive until the permissions have been assigned to them. So for an add user function, the user will need to also set their own password. Let me show you how the user can do it. But firstly, you have to assign the permissions to the user. So by doing this, you can I can identify this is the user that I've created, and I'll simply manage their permission and assign any single permission to them. Now that I've assigned the permission for this user, you will notice that the user status is now active. However, I have to initiate this create password process for this user in order for them to access ECP. Now, the key difference is that when you are inviting a user through the first way, the invited user on their own accord, they fill in all the user profile data, they create their own username as well as their own password. However, when you're creating a user via the add user method in ECP, the user has not created their password yet, and the password can only be done by the user themselves. So you have to initiate this create password flow to the user. So as a master admin, I'm going to do this by clicking this now. And this will actually send an email message to the user, instructing them on how to create their password for their account. So this has to be done by the user themselves. The master admin cannot do it for them. So your new user will have to go to their email inbox and retrieve this email. I'm going to submit it to now, and I will show you how this email looks like. So this is the email that I've just triggered. So it will say customer portal account information. So this is the first email. The customer will receive two different emails. The first one is to inform them that they have been granted access to the customer portal, and it will tell them their assigned username as well as the temporary PIN. But right now they are lacking the activation link. All right, so there are two emails that the customer will receive. The first email tells them the assigned username and the temporary PIN. The second email will give you the activation link that is sent in a separate email. So in this email, this is highlighted here. So they will need the activation link that is sent in a separate email. Let's trace the second email now. So this is the one. So with the information in the previous email, they can click on this activate account now. And this will bring them to the activation link. So now we are being asked for the assigned username and the temporary PIN, for which you can find it here. And the temporary PIN is 6465. And now the user will be prompted to select their language and input their new password. If the user does not complete these, the user will not be able to access ECP. And they will also need to set the service desk PIN. So as usual, this PIN is used to confirm their identity with the global service desk if they raise a help ticket. And now the user has successfully created their password, and they will be able to log into ECP immediately. So this is the flow for a create user as well as an invite user flow for the master admin and IBX admin when creating a new user.